Hi everyone, in today's video I want to start building a machine which will help us to cut getter strips into pieces. Let's call this machine a getter cutter. Let's first briefly explain what is a getter. You can find a getter in every or practically every vacuum tube. It's a part which acts like a filter. It catches impurities which evolves inside the tube during its operation, and it helps the inner space to stay clean. In high vacuum tubes it improves to keep the vacuum on high level. In Nixie tubes it works like a gas purifier. It helps the gas to stay clean. I will talk more about the getters and how they work, what types of the getters in some of the future videos, but for now let's say that purity of the gas inside Nixie tube has a huge impact on lifespan of the tube, so this is the reason why I struggle for as clean process of the cutting the getter as possible. As I already mentioned, the getter comes on a strip like this. It's a fine powder sintered on a nickel substrate, and the goal will be to make a machine which will cut this strip to pieces of exact length, because we want all the pieces to be as close in length as possible, because the length of the getter determines the pumping capacity inside the tube, and we struggle for as high consistency as possible in the manufacture. So this is the reason why we want to have all the getters the same length. So at the beginning we were cutting the getters by hand, by pliers. This was quite simple but also exhausting for our hands. It was also not so reliable because the result were getters of different lengths, and this is not what we want. So I decided to make some other way how to cut the getters. So I took a shear cutter and tried to cut the getters on the shear cutter. This worked quite well. The blades are sharp, they make a nice cut on the getters, but there was the same problem with the length of the getters, because I had to set the length manually. So I was looking for some kind of feeder which I could use together with this shear cutter. The first way what I wanted to try was inspired by filament extruder on 3D printer. There is a stepper motor and it rotates, and you can perfectly control the length of the extrusion in this case. Later I found better solution on YouTube. I found a system made of three air cylinders, and I made a prototype of this system and it worked perfectly, so I decided to use this way. The machine worked. It was very reliable, it produced the getter pieces of the same length in a very clean way. So from this point of view it was okay, but it was huge, bulky, it was not much safe to operate, because like there was this big shear cutter and I had to constantly take care so nobody can come and touch the blades. On the beginning I used two large air cylinders and they consumed too much air, so this caused our air compressor to constantly switch on and make a lot of noise. So I decided to take this machine, take all the working parts and redesign it and make it smaller, make it more reliable, and also once this is built I want to make it easy for someone else to operate. I will just explain how to operate it, and I want to delegate this work to other people so that I can spend my time on other jobs here.
This is the original feeder from first version of our getter cutter, and I'm now going to make few small changes to improve its functionality. First change is to redesign the clamps which holds the getter strip so that it cannot slip out of its track. With current clamps this sometimes happens. The piston rod is slightly greased here for a smooth operation, and because grease is quite dangerous for high vacuum, we need to prevent the getter strip from touching the rod. The final length of the getter piece is determined by travel distance of this piston. To set the right length of the getter, I need to put a stopper between these two parts. This system of stoppers worked fine, but exchanging them was quite difficult and time consuming, so the new version will use magnets instead of screw.
Because these parts are not symmetrical, I want to use on one side the magnets oriented like this and on the other side like this, so that the user of the machine cannot swap these parts. Only in one position there will be attracted. If you accidentally swap them, these plastic stoppers will be repelled by the magnets.